Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I will be talking about the expectations versus the reality of teaching English here in Japan. First, I'd like to apologize. I wasn't able to upload a video last week. I try my best to upload videos each week. I film on the weekends, but Since I was too busy with my new school, if you haven't known already, I teach junior high and I teach four schools but on a rotation basis. From April to June, I teach at one school, and then from July to September, I teach at a different school. And then I just moved to a new school, and this school is really demanding. So I was too busy at work, and I have a part-time job, so it was so difficult for me to juggle. It was so difficult for me to juggle both. So my apologies for that. I will really, really try my best to upload every week. Okay, so let's start. First, let's talk about Japan in general. So before coming to Japan, I was expecting that Japan is a beautiful country, it's a progressive country, it's a first world country, and they have trains that are very efficient, especially when you travel around the city. Indeed, the reality, it's a really, really nice country with clean public toilet. Next, let's talk about the people. The people in Japan, at first, I was expecting that the people will be very honest and very friendly, very hospitable, and in reality, they are indeed very honest. I can attest to that because I've lost some things. Knowing me, I'm very forgetful. The very first time I came to Japan, I stayed in a hotel. I lost my glasses, and then when I came back to the hotel, they had my glasses, so I was able to get it back. Next, what else? Oh, I lost my phone once in the bus from Osaka, and I forgot my phone in the bus. So I called the bus company and they found it. They returned my cell phone in one piece. And recently, I also lost a Suica card. It's the card that you tap when you ride the trains. Probably it fell on the street somewhere in, where was that? In Ikebukuro? I called Ikebukuro station, I think, and they found it. So I was able to get my card. So that's Japan. When you're a tourist here in Japan, you'll say that people are very polite, people are very welcoming, but in reality, once you settle down, or once you decide to live here in Japan, you realize that they're not really that polite. They are just obliged to be polite, but you know that in their hearts, they are not as polite as you think they are. They do the lip service, so they don't really tell you what they think inside their heads. Like, they try to sugarcoat everything so as to be nice to you, but in reality, it's not. Yeah, it's just not. Let's just accept that some of them are not really honest with their feelings towards you. So they try to hide their feelings, their real feelings, their true feelings deep inside so as not to hurt other people's feelings. But don't get me wrong, I have a lot of Japanese friends and they are really genuinely nice and friendly towards me. But when it comes to like co-workers, don't believe what they say, or just don't believe in everything that they say, good or bad. Next is the cost of living. So before coming to Japan, I was expecting Japan to be very, very expensive. And so when I came to Japan, indeed, it is very expensive. It was super expensive that I couldn't buy things. When I was grocery shopping for the first time, it was so hard for me to buy things, to buy goods, because I felt that it was too expensive. Like, let's say a can of Coke back in my country costs not even a dollar. Maybe it costs 50 cents, but here in Japan, it costs $1.20 or $1.50. And also, in the first few months here in Japan, I was always converting yen to my local currency back home. So probably when you just came to Japan, you'll find yourself converting a lot of times. Trust me, I did that a lot before, and that is very much normal. Indeed, Japan is a very expensive country, but there are some tips I'd like to share on my next video about how to save money here in Japan. I'd like to share how to save money, where to buy things, where to eat, so that will be next. Okay, let's talk about the most awaited part, the work. First, let's talk about the teachers. So before coming to Japan, I was expecting that the teachers in Japan will be the same as teachers back in my home country. Back in my home country, teachers are very, very close to each other. They treat each other as family. And yeah, they share things, they share food, they share gossips, and they act like family. You know, it's just one big happy family back in the Philippines. But here in Japan, that's not the case. The teachers here are very, very busy to a point that they won't have time to talk to you. And sometimes in the staff room or in the shokuinshitsu, you'll find yourself so lonely with no one to talk to. You feel like you're just a thin air, that you don't exist. And this is the reality. Also, for them, work is work. You can't be friends at work. I'm only talking from my experience. Well, of course, there are exceptions to everything because I've made friends with my co-teachers, but you know, not that close. Like, we don't send messages often, or we don't eat at restaurants often. And these teachers who I befriended with are the same age as me. I've never had co-teacher friends who are much, much older than me. So, you know, you should understand, because these teachers also have family to bond with. If you have younger teachers who are friendly to you, then you can be friends with them. So you can hang out from time to time, but do not expect them to hang out with you all the time, because they don't have time for that. Okay, next, let's talk about students. I only knew about the level I will be teaching 2 weeks after I came to Japan. I didn't really know what to expect, because my experience was only teaching kindergarten students. So I was expecting my students to be mature, but in reality, some of them are mature, some of them are not mature, and some of them are kind. Most of them are kind, and some of them are rude. Generally, Japanese students are okay. I mean, I'm talking about students in the countryside. I can't speak about the students in Tokyo or in Osaka or in other big cities, because I have no experience teaching in the cities. Some students are really friendly to you, and some are really aloof. Like, there are times when at school, these students will be very nice to you, but in reality, once they step out from the school, when you see them in supermarkets, they won't say hi to you. They will ignore you. That happened to me quite a lot of times when I was expecting my students to say hi, but they just ignore you. And I don't really know why they do that. But there are some students who are like really genki in class. When you see them outside of school, they will really approach you and say, "Hi, Kara-sensei! It's nice to meet you, blah, blah, blah." But it's half and half. Some students will do that, some students won't. Now let's talk about being an ALT, or an assistant language teacher. So before coming to Japan, my expectation was that I will really be a teacher teaching grammar, like SD, VDO, subject verb agreement, and all that. But in reality, it's not the case. Again, because the Japanese teachers of English, or the JTEs, teach the grammar part. You just play games with the students, like using the grammar point they learned. You make an activity out of the grammar point they are learning. So that's just your purpose. Another purpose for you is you become a cultural ambassador, which is great, because I get to share with my students the culture in the Philippines. And you know, you are representing your own country, you are representing America if you're an American. You make them aware that there are other countries, other cultures other than Japan that they should learn. Another expectation is that I will have a very packed schedule, and I will be very busy, and I will do overtime. But in reality, that is not again the case. In reality, you will teach maximum of 4 classes in a day. You should be at school by 8:30 in my case, and then you leave school around 3:50 or 3:35, depending on the school again and depending on the contract. And on Wednesdays, I get to go home earlier than the other days, because the teachers have a meeting right after school and I don't have to attend that meeting. Having experienced being a teacher in my home country, there are times when you you have no time to drink coffee or you have no time to log into your social media. But here in Japan, you have a lot of free time. You have a lot of prep periods. In most cases, you don't really need to prepare a lot of things or a lot of teaching materials because these teaching materials are already given to you by your dispatch company. Well, at least my dispatch company provides us with the worksheets, provides us lesson plans, so you don't really have to plan anything. So again, it depends on your dispatch company. So what I do on these free times, I plan my trips or I plan for my part-time jobs. Yeah, I just read a lot. And you can also learn Japanese if you want. There is this thing called karoshi. It means death by overwork. But that is not really happening in my case because I should only be at school 29.5 hours a week. So that's less than 7 hours a day. So I can't do overtime and they won't pay me for overtime and they can't demand overtime for me, which is a really, really good thing because, you know, you can do part-time jobs. Another expectation is that I will be active in school events or they will, you know, I will be there in school events. I will witness all the school events like sports day, sports activity, music festival, and all the other festivals. But sometimes you don't get invited at all. Like for example, there's a fire drill at school. One of my friends had a fire drill at school, but nobody, not even one soul, invited her or told her that on that day there will be a fire drill and that she should prepare for the fire drill. So she found herself alone in the staff room while everybody was out in the school ground doing the fire drill. It can really make you feel bad because you'll feel so left out, but just, you know, just brush it off. Life must go on. So you will really feel that you are not part of the school because in reality, you are not really an employee of the school. You are an employee of your dispatch company. That's why this makes them hesitant to invite you to school events or to school meetings or to enkais, to these drinking parties because you are not obliged to go because you are not an employee of the school. So just think of it that way so that you won't feel so bad. My advice to the ALTs who are experiencing everything I have just mentioned, my advice to you is to just do your job and make a life after school. Like pursue your interests. You can enroll yourself in a gym or you can jog around the lake. You know, you can make some vlogs, you can make YouTube like what I am doing. Make yourself busy after school so that you won't get bored. And if you find struggling in terms of your relationship with your teachers or with your coworkers or with your students, you know, just smile, because I find this very effective. There are some really scary teachers. I just smile at them, and to the students who are really aloof and distant and hostile, just smile, even if you don't get a smile back. Just smile, and then after some time, you'll get a smile back from them. I am not a very smiling person back home, but I learned to smile here in Japan. And if you are still planning to be an ALT, you should take this video by heart. My experience might be different from other ALTs' experience, so just be open to everything what I said and just prepare yourself. Prepare for the worst so that when you find yourself teaching already here in Japan and you find yourself not really experiencing the bad things I experienced, at least you know you're ready, you're prepared to face everyone. You need to approach the teachers and the students first, especially the teachers, because as a gaijin, these Japanese teachers will be very hesitant to approach you first, not because they don't like you or what, but it's because they are afraid to commit mistakes because they don't know, they're not really confident about their English. You know, just do small talks like, your blouse is nice or I like your pants, and you'll just be amazed that one day they will start talking to you and they won't stop talking to you. And lastly, my advice is that you study Japanese before coming to Japan, or at least you know how to read and write katakana and hiragana so that it won't be very difficult for you to shop, to do groceries, and to fill out some forms. You'll be filling out a lot of forms when you come here to Japan. Just be prepared, at least know how to write your name in katakana. I guess that's all. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you have some comments, more questions about being an ALT here in Japan, please drop some comments down below and I will be very happy to respond to each of them. And also, if you like this video, please thumbs up, click the like button, and please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. So that's all. Thank you and have a good day. Goodbye.